After a difficult non-conference season, St. Francis got back in the wins column with a big performance against Holy Cross this weekend. Now they're back home, taking on Governor State with a chance to make it two in a row. It's the Saints and the Jaguars coming up next. Just moments away from the start of tonight's game between St. Francis and Governor State. Terry Montanana standing courtside and joined by the head coach of the Fighting Saints, Ryan Marks. Coach, let's talk first of all about the big win this weekend against Holy Cross. What impressed you about your team's performance?
Yeah, I mean, we've been a resilient team through a lot of things. It was a game that we had to be resilient again. Holy Cross shot the ball great early in the first half, again in the second half. So both halves we had to sort of refine our footing in order to play better.
I feel like I've sounded like a broken record this year, talking about how this team is better than the record. A lot of overtime losses, a lot of really tough competition in non-conference play. But, you know, at some point you have to start getting those victories to see those results. You saw it on Saturday. How big was it just to get in that win column?
I think it's important, you know. Again, having played a lot of close games, particularly when you lose a few at the end, you hope that that doesn't weigh on your team, you know, mentally, psychologically at the end of other close games. But, you know, I mean, there's a reality to momentum. You know, like after a win like that, you get, on the ride home, everything's a little bit better. The sandwiches taste a little better. The mood is a little better, you know, all those things. And I think that carries over.
Team has had to deal with injuries this year, which is nothing new. I mean, every team has to deal with that, but it has made it a little bit difficult to have a steady rotation. How have you felt about the team lately in terms of the way that you've been able to establish a rotation and how they've played together?
Yeah, I think our guys have been very adaptable that way. They've done the best they could. Rarely have we had the same complement of guys even game to game this year outside of, you know, the guys that are out for the full season. But we have more guys off the bench, I think, making greater contributions as they get a little bit more comfortable. I think we're finding some different combinations we can use depending on what we're trying to get done at a certain time in the game. So that part of it's encouraging.
Governor State on the slate today. What kind of challenges do you expect from them?
Yeah, going to be a very difficult game. I mean, I think first and foremost, you know, year to year, they're always going to play you hard with a lot of energy. They try to create chaos with their defense, extending their defense, changing their defenses. So we've got to put a huge premium on handling the ball and not allowing them to get turnovers to transition points. They also have a lot of depth, and I think they're trying to fine-tune their rotation as well, and I think they've done some good things with that since the break.
Head coach Ryan Marks, thanks for your time. Good luck today.
Thanks, Terry. Appreciate it.
We got opening tip coming up next. St. Francis and Governor State here on the USF Sports Network.
The University of St. Francis in Joliet is a welcoming community of learners, ready to make you feel right at home. With a diverse student body that is a reflection of the community we serve, our students say over and over that USF truly feels like family. To get the excellent education and promising future you deserve, visit stfrancis.edu. Our home is your home. Make yourself comfortable at USF.
Hey there, back inside the Sullivan Center, St. Francis taking on Governor State in just a few moments now. Fighting Saints trying to make it back-to-back wins, which is something that's been a little bit hard to come by this year. The Saints haven't had an easy time getting on a roll over the first few months of the season. A lot of that non-conference play was about the schedule that they played, a very difficult non-conference schedule, a handful of ranked teams in there. A lot of those losses were very tight, came down to the last minute. Some of them went to overtime, double overtime in a couple of cases as well. So this is a team that hasn't played poorly over the course of the season. They just haven't been able to get into a solid rhythm that's extended from game to game, and a big part of that is some of the injuries that they've sustained. It seems like every time it looks like they're about to get a full complement of players, somebody else goes down. And even in a big win like they had on Saturday against Holy Cross, they were not without their casual team. So they're playing shorthanded once again today, but they are trying to pick up back-to-back victories and had one of their best team performances of the season on Saturday against Holy Cross, trying to follow it up with a good one against Governor's State today, a team that comes in with a record below 500, 5-9 overall for the season, so at least on paper, this is a winnable game for the Fighting Saints, and that does not mean that it's going to be easy. Governor's State's a team that always plays hard, always fights St. Francis anytime they come out here to Joliet. Today is expected to be no different. We'll have the opening tip in just a few moments, but right now, let's turn things over to the public address announcer, Alex Milcars, as we get the national anthem. Actually, the starting lineup's coming up next here at St. Francis.
At this time, let's introduce our starting lineups first for the visiting Governor State Jaguars. Senior guard number one, LaShawn Geist. Junior guard number 20, Kendall Brassfield. Junior forward number 22, Oluyemi Ilitulu. Junior guard number 24, Jeremiah Johnson. Junior forward number 30, Tyrell Ison. The Jaguars are coached by Tony Bates in his ninth season. And now, the starting lineup for your Fighting Saints. The redshirt sophomore from Wilmington, Illinois, the 6'5" forward, number 22, Ben Kreitz. Hailing from Pickerington, Ohio, the 6'1" graduate guard, number 2, Tay Jones. The 6'5" junior forward from Miramar, Florida, number 0, Ramel Davis. The 6'3" senior guard hailing from Kenai, Tikva, Israel, number 4, Nadav Gerner. And the 6'7" graduate forward from Mokina, Illinois, number 24, E.J. Charles. Your Fighting Saints are coached by Ryan Marks.
So there you've got the starters for today's game. St. Francis and Governor State going head-to-head for the first time this year. The Saints 3-8 overall, 2-4 in conference play, and coming off of their first victory since the month of November. They'll try to make it 2 in a row for the second time this year against a Governor State team that is 5-9 overall. Dead even in conference, 3 wins and 3 losses this year. One more time, the starters for the Fighting Saints, Davis, Jones, Gerner, Kreitz, and Charles. And for the Jaguars, Geist, Brassfield, Elitillo, Johnson, and Isom. Saints are in white, the Jaguars are in orange. It'll be LaShawn Geist going against E.J. Charles. On the opening tip, Charles has been playing some of the best basketball of his St. Francis career over the last couple of weeks, named the CCAC Player of the Week for his efforts 2 weeks ago, and had another good game in the win against Holy Cross on Saturday. The tip is won by the Saints, going from left to right to get us started today. Governor State goes from right to left. St. Francis looks to strike first. It's Ben Kreitz up top to Nadav Gerner. Gerner is guarded by Jeremiah Johnson. Half the shot clock is gone for Gerner as he dribbles it off to the right side, backing in, kicked outside to Tay Jones. E.J. Charles, the shot clock running low, has his pass deflected out of bounds. It'll stay with the Saints. 5 seconds to shoot. Gerner is the inbounder for St. Francis. They've got to get a quick one going here. Inbound it to Tay Jones. Jones has it poked away from behind, stolen by Governor State. Jeremiah Johnson on the run, pulls it up, slows things down. Good transition defense from St. Francis. This is Brassfield. Johnson for three, got it. Good start for Governor State. They strike first, leading 3-0. And the three-pointer from Jeremiah Johnson. Here's Ramel Davis. Up top, E.J. Charles, leading scorer this year for St. Francis. Charles averages 12.5 per game. Here's Ben Kreitz off a nice feed from Davis. Kreitz lays it in. Ben Kreitz came into play today averaging 2.7 per game. He's making his fifth start of the year in place of the injured Ben Fats, usually the starting center for the Fighting Saints. Fats is missing his fourth consecutive game. Little leaner is no good. That shot from Tyrell Isom. St. Francis can take their first lead of the game here. Just about a minute and 40 seconds into the action. Kreitz finds Davis. Davis steps up to the free throw line. Jumper a little bit long. Kreitz there for the tip. No good. Third effort. Rebound grab by Nadav Gurner. Nice job by the Saints down low, keeping it alive. And a whistle blows away from the ball. Pass was trickling towards the half court line. But a foul was called on Jeremiah Johnson down low on Governor State. First foul called today. And that gives the Saints new life with the shot clock resetting to 20. Gurner into Davis, layup is good. And St. Francis takes the lead for the first time today. Davis had the assist on the first bucket, now he's got the points. 4-3, Saints on top. Here's Geist, driving, nearly lost the ball, and he does lose it, but he's fouled. Foul called on E.J. Charles, getting him on the arm. First foul against St. Francis. Again, it goes against E.J. Charles. Down low, the layup misses from Geist right off the inbounds play. Governor State comes up empty. Tay Jones loses the ball. Gets it back, keeps it alive for the Saints. Here's Gurner cutting and kicking. E.J. Charles loses it, and an offensive foul called on Charles. So he's picked up two fouls in the last 30 seconds. And that certainly will impact his playing time the rest of the first half. He checks out. Connor Casper is in for the Fighting Saints. It's a big loss. Again, Charles is their leading scorer so far this year. And at least among active players. He's their leading rebounder as well, close to five a game. Ben Fats averages double that, but he's on the bench with an injury as a three-pointer falls for Oluyemi Elutillo. And Governor State reclaims the lead at 6-4. So a rough couple of moments for the Fighting Saints. Charles picks up two fouls, he turns it over, and then a three-pointer for Elutillo. Let's see if the Saints can get a grip on things here. Gurner dribbles up to the free throw line, bounces to the cutting Davis, and Davis lays it in. Saints have assists on all three of their buckets today. They're moving the ball very well. 6-6 our score, and an offensive foul is called on Governor State. The foul is on Jeremiah Johnson, and that's his second. So foul trouble on both sides early on, both E.J. Charles of the Saints and Jeremiah Johnson of the Jaguars are stuck at two. Johnson remains in the game for the moment. Connor Casper has it knocked away, but he keeps it alive in bounds. Tay Jones jumps into a three-pointer, knocks it down. First three of the game for Tay Jones, best shooter on the team at 46% from three-point range. Again, among active players, that's the best. Lewis McGlasson, a little bit higher percentage shooter, but he's out with an injury. There's a drive from Elutillo, gets into the paint and banks it in. One-point game, 9-8, USF on top. Over 4 minutes in. Jones down low to Casper. Casper kicks it into the corner. Three-pointer is off the mark from Gurner. Blocked from Ben Kreitz. Elutillo tried to take it inside again. Kreitz didn't let him. It'll stay with Governor State, but big-time defensive play from the sophomore Ben Kreitz. Jaguars inbound it. LaShawn Dantzler is the trigger man. Dantzler just checked in. Got it into George Ioannidis, who likewise just checked in, and Ioannidis is fouled. 2 free throws coming up for him. Ioannidis is a sophomore from Greece.
Kendall Brassfield at the line for two.
Excuse me, this is Kendall Brassfield shooting the free throws. First one is good. Now, Ioannidis never checked in. I saw something wrong there, obviously. This is Kendall Brassfield tying the score at 9. Second shot is good. Dylan Zalikoffer-White did check in for Governor's State, so he's on the floor with Kyle Jackson and LaShawn Dantzler, 3 subs for the Jaguars. The Fighting Saints have gone to the bench as well. Nick Nego, coming off of his best performance of the year, is out there. So is Kazmir Ochiaka. Nego is fouled, grabbed by Kyle Jackson. First foul on Jackson. 10-9, Governor's State. We've gone back and forth over the first 5 minutes of this game. Already 4 lead changes. Jones over to Davis. The only 2 starters still on the floor. Swung around to Nego on the left. Back up top, Jones. Deep 3-pointer. Tay Jones misses it short. And the rebound is knocked out of bounds. That was last touched by the team in orange. Money on the shot clock for the Fighting Saints. Inbounded to Ramel Davis, tough catch. Wanted a foul call as when it went up for the shot, didn't get the call. Here come the Jaguars, 3-pointer in the corner. That's Brassfield missing. Chases down his own rebound, misses again. Fight for the loose ball. Down on the floor, it's grabbed by Tyrell Isom, and the Jaguars get to start again. And they travel. Turnover committed by Governor State. Saints down by 1, get the ball back. Tony Bates, the only head coach in Governor State history, started the program a decade ago, still going strong with the Jaguars. Dakota Joakim is in for the first time for USF. Joakim's got it up top. Bounce down low. This is Ochiaka, double team. Ochiaka throws it away. Intercepted by Governor State. Here's Dantzler on the run ahead to Brassfield, and Brassfield lays it in. Four points for Kendall Brassfield. Governor State's got the 3-point edge. Casper around the screen, bounces down low. Ochiaka again double teamed, Davis double teamed, and he walks. So a traveling violation called on the Fighting Saints. Governor State gets the ball back, up by 3. .13:44 to play in the first half. Something of a low-scoring start to this one. Shooting has slowed down. Pull-up jumper from the free throw line. No good from Zalikoffer-White. Ochiaka grabs the rebound. Here's Joakim. Picks up his dribble, hands it off to Davis. Davis working inside, no good, but there's Joakim with the follow. A lot of contact inside with Davis going to the rim the last couple of times. Hasn't gotten the calls, but it all worked out for the Saints there. As Joakim picks up his first 2 points of the game. He's been a reliable bench scorer this year, averaging 7 points a game. Governor State comes up empty. Joakim slips and falls, no travel call as he gives it up from the ground. Davis, no good. Ochiaka is blocked. And it's going the other way. We had a nice back and forth start, but we've remained stable for the last few minutes. Both teams struggling to put the ball in the basket these last few minutes. Still a tight game though. 12-11 our score. This is Dantzler. Kyle Jackson with the shot clock under 10. Zollicoffer White drives, comes up short. Good challenge defense from Joakim. St. Francis can take the lead back here. Davis on the right side, looks to the corner, gives it up top to Joakim. Half the shot clock gone, and 12 minutes to play in the half. Joakim drives, falling away from the rim, no good. Good challenge from Zollicoffer White. Brassfield, good look from the outside, and he knocks it down. Dakota Joakim walks it up the floor. 4-point game. Biggest lead for either side so far today. First time it has not been a one possession contest. Davis tries to get it back there, and he's fouled from behind by Zollicoffer White.
Governor State foul, number 21, D'Lon White, his first, team's fourth.
So two free throws coming here for Ramel Davis. 68% foul shooter this year. Slightly better than the team average. First shot is good from Davis. 15-12 as the Saints go back to their bench. Ben Kreitz and Tate Jones return to the floor. Nadav Gurner will check in as well if Davis makes this free throw. Got them both. Good start today for Ramel Davis. 6 points out of the team's 13. He heads to the bench, gets his first breather of the day. Substitution for Governor State comes on late, Dakari Graham. Here's LaShawn Dantzler, working his way back to the middle of the floor. Kyle Jackson drives with the left hand. Jackson working against Nadav Gurner, turn around, got it in the paint.
Kyle Jackson.
Nice move by Kyle Jackson, his first points today. Lead is back up to 4 for the Jaguars. Gurner on the right wing, inside Ochiaka. Kazmir Ochiaka working hard, throws it with the left hand, no good, gets his own second chance, and he misses again. Dantzler works his way in on Gurner, loses his footing on the way to the basket, and a foul is called on Nadav Gurner.
St. Francis foul number 4, Nadav Gurner, his
first foul on Gurner. It is the 4th on the Fighting Saints. Injured man for Governor State down on the other side of the floor. We've got another look at this foul on Gurner. Turn that right shoulder into him. So he's got 1. EJ Charles has 2. Looks like a bloody nose for Kyle Jackson. That's why he was hunched over on the other side of the floor. So Jackson is being helped off the court right now. They're going to replace him. But I think that there was some blood that dropped onto the court. They've got to get cleaned up before we can continue here. I don't know what happened to Jackson that bloodied his nose, but he had to head off to the sideline to get that looked at. And of course, got to get the blood cleaned up off the court as well before we can continue play. So a little delay in the action here as they track down some cleaning supplies to make sure that any drops of blood get cleaned up. 17-13, Governor State has the lead. Their 4-point lead matches their biggest of this first half, and they'll get a chance to add to it coming out of this delay. They will have two free throws coming up. And there are a few different spots on the floor where he was bleeding, and so there are a few spots, obviously, that need to get cleaned up. Coming out of the break here, it looked like E.J. Charles was headed to the scorer's table, so he's going to come back in with 10 minutes and 32 seconds left in the first half. He had to leave after just a couple of minutes, picking up two quick fouls. Saints have held their own without him, but again, he's their leading scorer and rebounder right now for the season. So I don't want to play without him for too long. Ramel Davis, who averages 11 points per game, has picked up the slack in this first half. Off to a really nice start. He's got 6 points and an assist. And the Saints have hung around. St. Francis without Ben Fats once again today. They are without Lewis McGlasson, who went out on Saturday after having just returned to the lineup the game before. They have been shorthanded all year. And Ryan Marks talked about it before the game. They knew they had some significant injuries before the season that were never part of the team this year because they went down before game one. First free throw misses. One more coming from Dantzler. But even the guys they have had this year, a lot of them have been in and out of the lineup. Second shot for Dantzler. Misses as well. 0 for 2. And Charles grabs the rebound. Tay Jones from the free throw line. Quick shot and scores. Two-point game. Jaguars will try to make it a two-score contest again here. Zolikoffer White jump stop in the paint, and he lays it in. Nicely done by DeLon Zolikoffer White. The lead is back to 4. Here's Joe Kim over to Gerner on the left. Tay Jones at the elbow, lobs it out to Joakim. Shot clock under 10. Gerner drives down the lane, kicks it outside. Three-pointer Joakim. Good look, didn't get it. Offensive rebound Charles. Charles turns to face the basket. His jumper is no good. Here come the Jaguars. This is Dakari Graham from the corner. A two-pointer misses. An air ball. Jones has it poked away from behind. Charles keeps it alive. And a foul is called on Governor State. Fouls on DeLon Zolikoffer White. He leaves. Oluyemi Elatillo comes back in. Charles gets the inbounds pass. Outside Kreitz, three-pointer, a little bit short. St. Francis had a chance to pull within one. Their last lead was at 9-8. Governor State's controlled ever since. Turnaround jumper misses from Elatillo. Here come the Saints. Jones in a hurry. Ahead for Charles. Charles layup, no. Well defended by Tyrell Isom. And it's fired ahead. The layup is too strong from Geis, but a foul called on the Fighting Saints. Ryan Marks can't believe that that call went against St. Francis after they didn't get the call on the other side of the floor. Nadav Gerner called for fouling Eliemi, and that's his second. Free throw misses. Well, fouls are a problem early on for the Saints, but it's helped them that Governor State hasn't been able to make their free throws. Second shot is good. 20-15, biggest lead of the game for Governor State. Jalen Levy is in, defending Dakota Joakim. Tay Jones swings it around to the right side. Kreitz back up top to Jones. Good look from three. Jones has his second of the game. 8 points now for Tay Jones, a game high. And the Saints are within two. Ortillo passes to the cutter and a nice finish inside, Tyrell Isom. Junior out of Bogan High School. Governor State keeps their distance. Jones gets a screen going to his left. Gerner bounces down low, E.J. Charles. Charles takes it inside and he's fouled. So Charles goes to the free throw line. Get the Saints back on track.
E.J. Charles at the line for two.
Charles was double teamed as soon as Tyrell Isom backed away. He went towards the basket and Isom came back over late, called for the foul. First point of the day for E.J. Charles as Nick Nego returns to the floor. Dakota Jokum sits down. Charles hits them both. Good foul shooting early on for St. Francis. Here's a drive, pull up, baseline jumper, no good from Levy. St. Francis can tie or take the lead here, nearly taken away by Levy. Nego from the corner. No good on the three, but an offensive rebound. Ben Kreitz misses, challenged by Isom on the play. The Saints not able to get over the hump. A foul on E.J. Charles, number three. That's a bad foul that time on Charles in transition. You could see him trying to back off, and just didn't do so fast enough. So Charles has his third. He stuck his hands up there. You could almost see the wheels turning, recognizing he's got two fouls. He's got to lay off, but just couldn't avoid the contact. 7 minutes in the first half, and we likely won't see him again before halftime as Gerner grabs the rebound off the missed shot. Tay Jones slows things down for the Saints. Nego bounces to Gerner, inside to the cutting Kreitz, blocked and fouled. Kreitz has gone to the line. Ben Kreitz has been very active early on today. And he's really needed to be. Without E.J. Charles in there, he's had to shoulder a lot of the load inside, and he's done a pretty good job with it. 2 points so far for the sophomore forward. He misses the first free throw. E.J. Charles is on the bench with three fouls. Now Nadav Gerner checks out. He's got two. Connor Casper comes in for him. That foul, by the way, was the second on Tyrell Isom. So the Saints aren't the only team in foul trouble right now. Kreitz makes one of two. He's got 3 points. Just a one-point game. Jalen Levy drives, lays it up and in. Right-handed from the left side of the basket. Good drive by Levy, 24-21 Governor State. Saints swinging around the perimeter. Nego fakes, works his way inside, passes back out. Jones steps inside the three-point arc, misses the jumper. Rebound grabbed by Governor State. Nice block underneath. And here come the Fighting Saints. Ramel Davis slows it down. Here's Jones taking it back towards the half-court logo. Plenty of time to shoot here for the Fighting Saints. Davis on the right side. He's got 6 points. Gives it to the cutting Kreitz. Ben Kreitz is blocked to the rim by Isom. Knocked loose, the ball on the floor, it rolls out of bounds. It'll go the Saints' way. Governor State turns it over, 5:16 on the clock. They've led most of this first half. The Saints haven't let them pull away though. Been a one possession game most of the time. Tay Jones gives it to Nick Nego. Davis on the baseline. Tries the high arcing jumper, no good. Rebound grabbed by Isom. Saints have been slow going on offense of late. So is Governor State. That runner misses from Oluyemi Elotillo. Bounced inside Davis, blocking foul. They count it. Ravel Davis. Foul is called on Kendall Brassfield. Davis has 8 points. Not a chance now to make it 9. The Saints worked quickly on this possession. Davis took it quickly into Brassfield. I don't know that Brassfield was quite ready for that. Joakim comes in for Ben Kreitz. This is to tie the score. Davis, 2 of 2 at the line so far today. And we're knotted up at 24. First time it's been tied since it was 9-all. Governor State has led most of the half. They'll try to take that lead back right here. Kendall Brassfield drives. He's fouled and he finishes. Good drive by Kendall Brassfield.
St. Francis foul number 2, Tay Jones, his first, team 7. Brassfield at the line for 1.
So Brassfield has already given Governor State the lead back. And he extends that lead from the free throw line. A 3-point play for Brassfield. He's got 10 points now to lead all scorers. Just about 4.5 minutes to play, first half. Nego gets the screen. Fired into the corner. Tay Jones back outside. Casper for 3. Well short. Lobbed in front of the rim, and the alley-oop is finished by Jalen Levy. He lays it off the backboard. Timeout called by St. Francis as they face a 5-point deficit. They have trailed most of this half, but usually it's been 2 or 3 points. They came back tied it at 24, and now Governor State has gone on one of their best pushes of the game with 5 consecutive points, making it 29-24. Nice play in transition. Levy able to finish. That was one of the keys to the game that beforehand. Good transition defense. There hasn't been a huge need for it so far today because Governor State hasn't had a lot of opportunities to run out ahead of the defense, but right there they took advantage. Other keys for Ryan Marks: minimize turnovers and capitalize on free throws. They certainly have done well from the free throw line early on, and turnovers haven't been a problem. So far so good on a lot of these issues that he highlighted before today, but the problem for the Saints has been a little bit of a sluggish offense. They haven't been turning it over a lot. They're just not making a lot of shots early on. Try to start finding that rhythm right here. It hasn't been a bad offensive half for either team. Nobody's lit up the scoreboard so far, though. Connor Casper working hard in the paint. Turnaround, no good. Davis gets the offensive rebound. Second chance, he's fouled. And the Saints will get another chance to capitalize from the free throw line.
20, Kendall Brassfield, his second.
Second foul on Kendall Brassfield. There have been a lot of fouls this half, 16 of them total. And both teams have had some guys in foul trouble. First of 2 shots for Davis is good. He's up to 10 points already. First double-digit scorer on St. Francis. He and Tay Jones have combined for 18 of the 25. Got them both. Back to a one-score game, 29-26. Jalen Levy handles the ball for Governor State. There's Elotillo. Down to the corner, Isom. Isom working along the back line. Reverse layup, no. Rebound tipped. And chased down by Nigo, who taps it over to Joakim. Davis out on the run, no good with the layup. Offensive rebound and a kicking call against the Jaguars. Looking to get it in. Joakim finds Davis. Davis turnaround, got it. 1 point game thanks to the hard work of Ronell Davis. 13 points. Just about half the total for St. Francis here. Dakari Graham fighting his way inside. Offensive foul. Dakota Joakim takes the charge, and the Saints force the turnover. Big time defensive play by Joakim there. He's got his bench fired up. And now we'll see if the Saints can carry that over to offense and reclaim the lead. It's Joakim picked up by Levy. Half the shot clock gone. Casper back to the top. Lob down low. Ramel Davis immediately double teamed. Backs in, kicks it out to an open shooter. Casper for the lead. No good. Rebound tapped by George Ioannidis. Off to Jalen Levy. Now Levy on the move, lays it in. Saints wanted a travel. They wanted a double dribble, some kind of violation. Nothing called on Jalen Levy. And then the Jaguars get two more points out of it. Ioannidis jumps the passing lane. And he's stripped by Joakim, who keeps it inbounds. Good hustle defensively for the Saints sophomore. Now through the hands of Joakim on offense. Ball loose on the floor. Joakim tries to cover it up, and he's got a foul call. Foul on George Ioannidis. And the Saints catch a break there. Things have been a little bit sloppy these last few possessions for both teams. But Joakim goes to the free throw line. They are in the double bonus now. Dakota Joakim shoots 70% from the line. He's got 2 points so far in tonight's game. And there's number three. Minute 47 to play in the half. This to make it a 1 point game. Got them both. Ben Kreitz checks in for Joakim. Close game. It has been close throughout the first half. We've been tied thrice. We've had four lead changes. Biggest lead was five. Here's a drive and a foul called. Dakari Graham is going to go to the line. Foul on Nick Nigo. Number two on Nigo. Get another look at this one. Graham was able to get the first step on him. Nigo made the contact on the way in. Two for him, two for Gerner, three for Charles. Graham's free throw is no good. Free throw shooting has been a huge plus to St. Francis today. Jaguars really struggling from the line. Dakari Graham is just 58% for the season. He misses them both. They cannot hit from the line right now. And that has been a huge boon to the Fighting Saints' chances. They've been great on their free throw attempts. Casper over to Kreitz. 10 on the shot clock. Hand off to Tay Jones. Kreitz well behind the line, takes a step forward, gives it to Jones. Shot clock running out. Jones fires a three and hits to give St. Francis the lead. It's not the shot that he wanted. But with 2 seconds on the clock, he had no choice but to take it. And he puts St. Francis ahead, 33-31. Their first lead since the first few minutes, and now the lead is gone. Tyrell Isom on a little floater makes it 33-33. Tay Jones pressured in the backcourt, gets it across the timeline. Here's Jones walking to the left, Kreitz. Into the post, Ramel Davis. Davis, turnaround jumper, a little bit short. Rebound tracked down by Casper. New start for the Saints. Ryan Marks wants them to hold on for the final shot here. There are 3 second difference between the shot and game clocks here. But the Saints can run it down and prevent Governor State from getting another chance. Davis on the run, scores and puts the Fighting Saints in front. Half-court heave at the buzzer, off the rim, no good from Dakari Graham, and the Fighting Saints will go into halftime with the lead. 35-33 our score. We went back and forth early. Governor State took the advantage for the majority of the half, but the Saints finished strong, and they go into the intermission ahead 35-33. They'll try to finish this one off and pick up their second consecutive victory, something they've pulled off just one other time this year. They look to pick up a big conference victory. It would be their third of the year if they can pull it off. 20 minutes of basketball still ahead of us. All of that coming up in about 15 minutes' time. For right now, I'll step aside. St. Francis 35, Governor State 33, halftime in Joliet. We're back inside the Sullivan Center. Terry Bonadonna with you once again as the Fighting Saints host the Jaguars of Governor State University in CCAC action today. The first of two meetings between these two teams this year, and so far so good for the Saints. They didn't shoot the ball very well in the first half. They were without a couple of their key players for a majority of the half due to foul trouble, and yet they've got a two-point lead. They shot just 31% in that first half. Governor State a lot better than that, but a huge difference at the free throw line. The Saints really kept themselves in the game, knocking down their foul shots. They went 10 of 11 from the line. The Jaguars just 4 of 9 shooting free throws in that first half. But Saints need contributions from more players in the lineup. E.J. Charles was held to under 5 minutes on the court in the first half. He picked up 3 fouls. Nadav Gurner sat for a good chunk of the first half as well with 2 fouls. So they're hoping that the reinsertion of those two players in the lineup in the second half is going to make a little bit of a difference in this game. But right now it's really just been two guys, Tay Jones and Ramel Davis, have kept things afloat for the Fighting Saints. Davis has 15 points on 5 of 14 shooting. Jones 11 points on 4 of 6 from the field. And the rest of the team combined just 2 total field goals. So obviously that's something they need to address in the second half. 4 points for Dakota Jokim off the bench. 4 rebounds for Kazmir Ochiaka, and E.J. Charles lead the way. Governor State led today by Kendall Brassfield. He's got 10 points on 3 of 5 shooting. They've been a little bit more balanced scoring-wise. They've seen 7 different players score at least 2 points, and a lot of that is from the field right now. We heard the St. Francis stats. Most of their production has come from the free throw line, or a lot of their production has come from the free throw line. 10 foul shots made to 11 field goals. Governor State actually led the majority of that first half. St. Francis was able to come from behind late and take the lead back. It was back and forth early. We had 4 ties, 5 lead changes in the half, but Governor State led for a solid 15 plus minutes in that game, and they find themselves trying to come from behind at the half. 35-33 is our score. And the Saints come out with 4 of their 5 starters, Jones, Gurner, Davis, and Kreitz. E.J. Charles will remain on the bench for the start of the second half. Remember, he's got 3 fouls, so Connor Casper is out there in his place. Governor State lines up with Ilotillo, Jeremiah Johnson, who also missed most of the first half because of foul trouble, Tyrell Isom, Dakari Graham, and Kendall Brassfield are out there right now for the Jaguars. So their ball as we start this second half. Graham holds on the wing, guarded by Casper. Here's Brassfield driving on Davis. Brassfield spins, shot is good. Nice move by Kendall Brassfield. And he ties the score at 35. Tay Jones works it inside, pulls back out. Jones to Casper, good ball movement out to Kreitz. Kreitz, jump shot from the wing, misses the 3. A defensive rebound for Brassfield. Brassfield works it all the way in, blocked by Kreitz, and knocked out of bounds by Governor State. Big time defense from Ben Kreitz.
It's Fighting Saints basketball.
Kreitz has played well today, hasn't necessarily shown up on the stat sheet. He's got 3 points, 3 rebounds, a couple of assists, and that's now his 2nd block of the game. So nothing gaudy among those numbers, but he's done everything pretty well. Casper drives, bounces to Davis, who lays it up and in. Ramel Davis's stat sheet, on the other hand, has been gaudy. 17 points for Davis. He leads all scorers, and the Saints lead the game, 37-35. Pull-up jumper, Jeremiah Johnson.
Johnson
showing what Governor State was missing out on in the first half. Johnson sat for most of that half, played only 6 minutes before picking up his 2nd foul. He's back out there and playing well in the second half. 38-37, Governor State back in front. Davis has it poked away from behind by Isom, and the loose ball secured by Dakari Graham. 2-on-2, and Isom throws it down.
Tyler Isom.
3-point lead for the Jaguars. Here's Gurner walking to the right. Up top, Tay Jones. Back around to Gurner. Jones from the top. Three-pointer is good. Tay Jones hits another three-pointer. He's 4 of 5 from beyond the arc. He's got 14, and the second half picks up right where the first left off. The Davis and Jones show for St. Francis. Here's Oluyemi Elatillo for Governor State, putting them back in front. It has been those two guys time and again tonight for the Saints. Governor State getting contributions up and down the lineup. They played each other pretty much to a standstill. Gurner out to Kreitz, three-pointer, rims out. Offensive rebound, Davis back up, no. Third chance, got it in one. Davis has had a huge night and a chance to add one more. Second offensive rebound in a row for Davis. Got it back, went right back up with it. Came up short, but the tip in is there. And Tyrell Isom has his third foul, and that would be a big loss for Governor State if he has to spend significant time on the bench. Team's leading scorer and rebounder this season. Davis for the lead, makes the free throw. Saints remain hot from the line now, 11 of 12. Shooting free throws today. Davis is 6 for 6. Graham to the top and Elatillo. There's a pull up for Brassfield, short. Rebound grab by Tay Jones. Biggest lead for St. Francis today has been 3. They can match or exceed that here. Casper on the cut, has a wide open layup. Beautiful cut from Connor Casper. Ramel Davis found him. And Davis has his second assist of the game. Isom pull-up jumper, too strong. Rebounded by Kreitz. Nadav Gurner drives to the right side. Pulls his way out of the corner. Gurner on the wing. High pass, Kreitz reels it in. Shot clock under 10. Tay Jones from 2-point range, good. Biggest lead of the night for St. Francis, and Tony Bates is feeling it. He calls timeout for Governor State. St. Francis on a 7-0 run. They take a 47-42 lead. Tay Jones is having a great night. Shooting the basketball, he's been fantastic. And not to take anything away from what Ramel Davis has done with his 20 points, but those 20 have come on 14 field goal attempts. Tay Jones has 16 points on just 8 shots. It's been incredible. And a lot of those shots from Tay Jones have been long range shots, and they've been with a hand in his face, including this one right here with the shot clock running down. His steps moved to get a step on Dakari Graham, and that was all he needed. Graham reached in at the last second, but had no recourse for what Jones was offering. 4 of 5 from 3-point range tonight. The rest of the team has gone a combined 0 for 8 shooting from long range. And that's been the biggest key, I think, to what Davis and Jones have done tonight. Two of them have combined for 36 of St. Francis' 47 points. But it's not just that they've had great nights, it's on a night where the rest of the team has kind of gone cold. You take away their production, and St. Francis has gone just 3 for 21 from the field. Make it 3 for 20 from the field, from the rest of the team. So it's great when two of your key players step up and have big nights, but it's even bigger when they're able to do that on a night where nobody else has been able to get it done. E.J. Charles is St. Francis's leading scorer this year. Charles has only played 6 minutes tonight because of the fouls, and those other two guys have stepped up. Of course, Ben Fats is out. Lewis McGlasson is out. That's three of your top five scorers on the season who have been out either because of fouls or injuries. And the Saints are still able to build a five-point lead. Here's Isom at the free throw line, driving on Casper. Isom, nice fake, turns back to the right and hooks it in.
Tyrell Isom.
Good play by Tyrell Isom, 16-point-per-game scorer, who now has eight in this one. Just under 15 minutes to play. High pass through the hands of Connor Casper and out of bounds. Three-point game. Jeremiah Johnson takes it down the floor for Governor State. Grassfield bounces into Isom, no good. And the rebound goes to Jones. Tay Jones leading the charge. All the way in, off the glass, no good. Rebound Isom. Grassfield races across half court. Brassfield pulls up from two-point range and gets the bounce. Wide open jumper for Kendall Brassfield. He's got 14 points. St. Francis's lead is down to one. Kreitz, cross court, Jones fakes it, gives it up. Dakota Jokin finds Davis underneath, and Davis lays it in for another two. Saints maintain their lead. Ahead by two at the half. Now we've got a whistle here. Kendall Brassfield is hurt.
Timeout for injured player.
Brassfield, you could see him wincing coming down the floor on the last possession. It didn't stop him from knocking down a pull-up jumper. And then he stayed in the game to play defense, but obviously was still feeling whatever that twinge in his leg was. So he sits down for now. Play continues. Dakari Graham handling the ball for Governor State. And foul called on Tay Jones. It's a tough matchup for Jones.
St. Francis foul.
Guarding a 6'5 Tyrell Isom.
Team's first in the second half.
Jones gives him a little bump from behind, and he's called for his first foul. Make that his second foul. First foul of the half on St. Francis. Fouls were a big storyline in the first half. Not so much here. Three-pointer no good from Elitillo. Here come the Saints, looking to extend their three-point lead. Jokin loses his footing, but not control of the ball. Davis inside, floats it up and in. 24 points for Davis. Saints match their biggest lead at 51-46. Flipped up, no good from Jackson. Travel is called on St. Francis. So after Jackson missed the shot, Saints got it right back, but Davis, who's been great on the other end of the floor, makes a mistake on this side. EJ Charles comes in. Davis gets a breather here. Charles has been on the bench for the last 14 minutes of game time, plus halftime. It's been a long time since Charles has been out there. Three-pointer for Jeremiah Johnson, high off the rim, no good. Rebounded by Tay Jones. Charles gives it to Jones. Lob for Kazmir Ochiaka at the free throw line. Charles in the corner. Ochiaka with seven to shoot. Spins inside, misses, and the rebound is grabbed by Governor State. Here's Greg Foster getting some action for the first time. Passes off to Zolikoff for White. Johnson bounces down low. It's Graham. Graham working against Ochiaka. Passes loose, knocked towards the baseline, out of bounds. It'll stay with Governor State. 7 seconds on the shot clock. Graham lobs it into Johnson, who chases it down behind the three-point line. Here's Dakari Graham. 2 seconds to shoot. Graham's got to get one up, and he didn't. His desperation shot did go in, but it was not off on time. It's a shot clock violation. The Saints forced the turnover, and they'll get the ball back up by five. E.J. Charles passes to Kazmir Ochiaka. Off to the right side, Joakim feigns the three, steps in. Two-point jumper is good. 7-point lead. This is the Saints' biggest. Starting to create some separation between themselves and Governor's State here as we approach the midway point of the second half. Lob down low, turnaround misses for Zolikoff for White, but the Saints can't secure the rebound. Another chance here for the Jaguars. Three-pointer for Isom, misses, and the rebound grabbed by Ochiaka. Isom does a lot of things well. Three-pointers, not usually part of his game. That was only his third attempt this year. The Saints were happy to let him shoot it. Here's Jones. Jones spins his way to the right. Fadeaway jumper misses off the rim. Fight for the rebound. And finally, grabbed by Isom, and Governor State takes over. Here's Zolikoff for White cutting to the basket. He lays it in. Dakota Joakim takes his time setting up the Fighting Saints offense. Charles out to Joakim. Bounce down low. E.J. Charles working against Greg Foster. Six to shoot. One-on-one, and now the help comes in, and Charles is fouled. DeLon Zolikoffer-White got him. Just the second foul of the half on Governor State. What a difference from half to half.
Governor State foul.
There were 19 total fouls called in the first half.
Greg Foster, his first team second.
That was the third total of this second half. One on the Saints, two on the Jaguars. Free throws were a big part of the first half storyline. They have hardly come into play here in the second. Inbounded to the corner, it's Nick Nigo missing the three. Rebound knocked out of bounds, and that was last touched by Greg Foster. Kendall Brassfield comes in for Greg Foster. Bounced into Ochiaka, working hard down low, blocked by the bottom of the rim, gets it back and scores on the second chance. 55-48.
Kazmir Ochiaka with the basket.
And a technical foul called on Ochiaka, I think. For his reaction after scoring. So it's the first foul on Ochiaka. Saints were on a roll here. This will put a little bit of a halt to that as DeLon Zolikoffer-White goes to the line. First free throw is good. Governor State had been just 4 of 9 from the line prior to that one. But they make one of two here. It's not so much a but. I was going to say they get to pick their own shooter this time. They went with Zolikoffer-White, who is their best foul shooter, 80%. And even he makes only one of two. Foul shooting has just not been a friend to Governor State today. The lead is 6 for the Fighting Saints. Ochiaka scored and then was called for the technical. So ultimately, he comes out on the positive. He got 2 points out of the play and only gave up one. Here's a drive from Isom, turned away by Joakim, gets it back, and that's a travel. Isom is kind of throwing his body all over the place right now, looking for a foul call. Didn't get one. And eventually you throw yourself around on the court enough trying to draw contact, it usually comes back to bite you, and that's what happened right there. Joe Kim over to Nego. Bounced inside to E.J. Charles. Charles backs in, kicks back out to Joe Kim. Six to shoot. Dakota Joe Kim drives with the right hand, kicks it out to Nego. Shot clock running down. Jumper from Nego is an air ball. Rebounded by Jalen Levy. Here come the Jaguars, down six with 9 minutes to play. Kendall Brassfield just inside the free throw line. Jumper misses, offensive rebound. Shot clock does not reset. It's at 15 seconds. Tyrell Isom kicks it outside. This is Brassfield. Gets the contact, misses the shot, but it'll go to the line. It's on to Dov Gurner, number three on him. Kendall Brassfield, just a 54% free throw shooter. Perfect from the line today. He's the only one who is for Governor State. He's 4 for 4. The rest of the team has gone 2 for 8. But Brassfield, who's not a good foul shooter typically, has been the one man they've been able to count on today. 15 points overall to lead the team. He rattles home the second. Just a 4-point game. It was kind of starting to feel like St. Francis was beginning to take control of this game, but Governor State has not let them pull away, and it remains close. Coming down to the final 8 minutes. Nadav Gurner passes to his left. This is Charles. Ball is lost. Isom going after it, and a foul is called on St. Francis. That's number 4 on E.J. Charles. Charles has been out there for the last 6 minutes. He only played 6 minutes total in the first half. So he finally was able to start getting to some kind of flow, but losing the ball essentially cost him the foul there. Zollicoffer White kicks it outside to Levy. Here's Jalen Levy with a shot clock under 10. He drives into traffic. He's blocked by Charles. And Ramel Davis is fouled. Big block from Charles. He did not depart after picking up his fourth foul. Yeah, it's a good thing he didn't, although he will come out now. They needed him on that last defensive possession, though. Connor Casper comes in for him. Ben Kreitz also back in the game as Casimiro Chiaka sits down. Full court press from Governor State. Gurner across half court. Nadav Gurner sends it to the outside. It's Casper. Down low, Davis, and Davis scores off the glass. Davis had been quiet, sat on the bench for a few minutes, and since coming in, hadn't seen the ball very much, but he gets a touch inside here and gets right back into the groove. 26 points for Davis. Zollicoffer White blocked by Davis. Or Isom, rather, blocked by Davis. Here's Davis on the other end. Layup, no. Rebound to LaShawn Dantzler. Three-pointer from the right wing. Misses the mark from Kendall Brassfield. Saints have a 6-point lead with 7 minutes left. Timeout called. There's a little bit of confusion on the bench, but it is a timeout for St. Francis. I don't think Ryan Marks wanted the timeout there. It worked out, though, because the ball was knocked away from Nadav Gurner. And it would have been a turnover had he not been granted the timeout. I think, I didn't see where that ball went. I think it might have gone out of bounds, actually. It's all hypothetical, it doesn't really matter. 57-51, St. Francis has the lead. They've led the whole second half after trailing almost the whole first half. It's been an interesting game. Seven ties, seven lead changes, but both of these teams have gone through long stretches with the lead. For Governor State, it was most of the first half. They never led by more than five, but they were up most of the way until St. Francis wrestled that lead away from them. Over the last couple of minutes, they carried a 35-33 advantage into halftime. And the second half, Governor State was able to take an early lead back from St. Francis, but the Saints jumped out in front with a 7-0 run, and they have not looked back. They've been up ever since 43-42. Biggest lead was 7 points. It's at 6 right now. They're trying to make it their biggest lead of the game with a bucket on this possession. Gerner in the corner, 7 seconds on the shot clock. Gives it up to Kreitz, cutting to the hoop, and Kreitz lays it in. 5 points for Kreitz tonight. And it is the biggest lead of the day, 8 points for St. Francis. And Governor State starting to run out of time just a little bit. A lot of time to come back and win this game for them, but they've got to shore up the defense. Isom dribbles in from the right side, knocked away. Gerner has the steal. Here comes Davis. Saints have numbers. Davis pull up, no good. Rebound Casper, kicked out to Kreitz. Nick Nego at the top. Misses the three. He's had a rough shooting night. Fight for the rebound won by Kendall Brassfield. Brassfield on the move, all the way inside. No good off the glass. Gets his own rebound. Second chance, yes. 18 for Brassfield. Governor State sticking around in this thing. Gerner gives it to Davis, flipped back outside. Nadav Gerner thought about the three, gives instead to Davis in the post. Underneath the basket, Ben Kreitz left unaccounted for, and an easy two for him. 7 for Kreitz now, including the last 4. Dantzler bounces to Zolikoff for White. One-on-one with Casper, kicks it outside, cross court, it's Levy. Jalen Levy drives with the left hand. He's fouled on the floor, no shot. Foul called on Nick Nego. Number 3 on him. He leaves. Tay Jones is back in. Nego bumped him right there, so well before the shot. Zelatillo bouncing it to Zolikoff for White. Turnaround jumper, no good. Rebound Ben Kreitz. Gerner into the corner for Davis. Tay Jones had a big shooting night. He's sitting at 16 points. Kreitz tried to get it to the cutter, but he threw it behind Ramel Davis. And the Saints turn it over. Dantzler walks it to the left. Around the screen to the free throw line, kicks it outside. Zolikoff for White pulls up, jumper no. Davis works against Jalen Levy. Kreitz whips it to the cutter. It's Nadav Gerner this time, shoveled off to Casper, who lays it in. Good possession for the Fighting Saints, and Connor Casper lays it through. His second field goal today. Double-digit lead for the first time at 63-53 with 4 minutes to go. Melitillo hits a big three-pointer. Governor State needed that one badly. 63-56 the score. Timeout called. It is a full timeout. A good chance for us to talk about what this game means for the CCAC standings. Neither of these teams right now challenging for the top, but St. Francis could even up with Governor State on that standing sheet, and come season's end, it will be the top 8 teams that make it into the conference tournament. So this could be a huge win for St. Francis to pull them up to 3-4 in conference play. The Saints have played a tough schedule so far this year. They lost last week to Olivet Nazarene. They've also got losses to Indiana Northwest, who's ahead of them in the conference standings. And St. Ambrose, a double overtime game early in the season, who's up near the top of the conference as well. So their losses have come against teams that are contending for the top. Indiana South Bend was their other conference defeat. So this is a team that I've been talking about it all year. They have performed better than their record would indicate. And I don't think that Ryan Marks believes this is a team that's not going to finish in the top eight in conference play. But as we talked about before the game today, at some point you've got to show it, not just with the way that you've played, but with your results. They got one on Saturday. They're in good shape to get one today, but a lot of basketball still to be played here. With the score at 63-56 and just under 4 minutes to go. Good press break from the Fighting Saints. Gurney makes the first points today for the senior point guard. Dav Gurner puts the Saints up by 9. Brassfield spins into the lane, too hard off the glass. St. Francis can again go ahead by double digits here. They worked very quickly on their last possession. Scoring, they'll run the show a little bit. Get into that second counts for Governor State. Davis in the paint, rims out. And an over the back foul called on the Fighting Saints. Number four, nope, never mind. I thought they were going to call that on Nadab Gurner. Number one on Ben Kreitz. Yeah, clearly on Kreitz. The reason I thought it was Gurner, I saw him put his hand up. Usually a guy puts his hand up to indicate it was his foul. He was actually waving to somebody on the bench for a different reason, just trying to get their attention. He obviously wasn't involved in the play. The foul was on Kreitz. Drive from Elatillo, and he puts it in with the layup. Oliemi Elatillo is coming up big here late. He's been quiet for most of the second half, but he has scored the last five for Governor State when they beat it the most, keeping them in the game. Gurner double teamed. He's picked up his dribble and he gets it off to Joakim. Now the ball loose on the floor. Kreitz scoops it up and Kreitz is fouled. It's on Jeremiah Johnson. Could have been disaster for St. Francis there. Gurner completely trapped. Nice job by Dakota Joakim to keep that ball alive and tap it to a teammate. It's only the fourth foul on Governor State. So 2:46 to play. Saints are not in the bonus yet. E.J. Charles, wide open beyond the arc, elects not to shoot the three. Instead, he puts it on the floor, and he's fouled by Tyrell Isom. That's the fifth, and that's a little bit later in the shot clock, I'm sure, than Governor State would like, and they're certainly not at a point in the game where they're intentionally fouling. But it's not a bad thing for them. Now that we're down to 2.5 minutes and it is a three possession game, they're probably going to have to start fouling at some point to keep themselves in the game. And they want to make sure that the Saints are in the bonus when they do. So that got them one closer. Jones to Kreitz, knocked away, but Kreitz keeps it alive, under 10 to shoot. Tay Jones drives, Jones loses the ball. Underneath the rim, E.J. Charles tries to pull it in, but can't get it cleanly. So here's Johnson on the other end. A drive from Levy. Jalen Levy stops short. Rebound grabbed by Dakota Joakim. Here come the Fighting Saints. It's Nadav Gurner. Gurner gives it to Joakim. Down to the corner, Tay Jones decides not to take the shot. Jones double-teamed. Dribbles and passes off to Joakim, whose pass is deflected, but right to Tay Jones. 5 on the shot clock. Jones steps to his right, jumper no good. Charles, second effort, good, and a foul.
E.J. Charles, the hoop at the horn.
Well, it's not game over just yet, but boy, it has really put the Jaguars in a tough spot. This could be a 10-point game here with just 97 seconds left. This free throw would make it a 4-possession game. Big play from Charles. Charles has been playing some great basketball the last few weeks. He's essentially been a non-factor for most of today's game because of fouls, but he makes a big play when he needs to. It leaves the door open a crack by missing the free throw. Still a 3-score game. Johnson backs in. Turnaround jumper is good. Still just a 7-point game. Don't write the Jaguars off yet. Timeout called by St. Francis. A minute 23 to play. St. Francis in control of this one. They've led the whole second half, or most of it anyway. But Governor State has hung around. Saints have led by as many as 8 points, or nine. Should say they were just by 9 in a minute ago. Actually, I was looking at an old stat sheet. They've led by as many as 10 in this game. 63-53 was the score at peak for St. Francis. They led by 2 at the half. They have shot the ball much better, and they played a better team game in this second half, getting contributions up and down the roster sheet. Remember that first half, it was really just Davis and Jones doing all of the scoring. The rest of the team at one point was just 3 of 20. Well, here in the second half, it's been a different story. Everybody's shooting well. 54% overall from the field this half for St. Francis compared to 37% for Governor State. And that has allowed the Fighting Saints to stay in front. It is their ball coming out of a timeout. You can expect the Jaguars to put on a full court press. They've been doing that down the stretch of this game. No problem with it for the Saints so far. Keep in mind, down the stretch here, a bunch of players in foul trouble. E.J. Charles has 4 of them for St. Francis. For Governor State, Jeremiah Johnson and Tyrell Isom both have 4, and they are both still on the floor for this defensive possession. Charles inbounds it to Kreitz, who gets it back to E.J. Saints still have to get it across the timeline. They do. And now they can run a little bit of clock here. They can run it under a minute. Charles drives, and he's fouled.
Governor State foul, number 20,
foul is called on Kendall Brassfield. That's number 3 on him.
E.J. Charles at the line for 2.
2 free throws for E.J. Charles. He missed his attempt on the last possession, but he makes this one. It's going to have to be the free throw game from here on out if Governor State wants to have any chance to win, and that doesn't bode well for them because the Saints have been lights out from the line tonight. Maybe jinxed them there. They had been 86% prior to that. Here's Johnson, step back 3. Got it to go. Jeremiah Johnson keeping his team alive with 5 straight points. And now just a 5-point game. Charles ahead to Jones. Tay Jones gets it across the timeline. Nearly lost the ball. Passes out of the trap, finds Davis. And now Governor State may have to foul. Davis hounded by Johnson, lobs it off to Jones. They're letting them play out the possession. E.J. Charles takes it inside. Charles in the paint, layup, yes! And so not only do they score 2, but they use up over 25 seconds on the clock. And now a foul on Gerner. Number 7 on the Saints, so it's a 1-1 for Governor State.
St. Francis foul number 4 to Don Gerner, his 4th, team 7th. Jalen Levy at the line for 2.
Big free throws for Levy here, 1-1. Remember, Governor State has not shot the free throws well today. Levy's a very proficient shooter on the season, over 80%. He makes that one. So that makes it a 2-score game. McNego comes in from Ben Kreitz, an extra free throw shooter. Governor State, no doubt this time, will have to foul St. Francis right away if they can't get a quick steal. But there's no time to spare anymore, down by two possessions with under 30 to play. Knocked out of bounds. Last touch by Governor State. So another missed free throw for the Jaguars. It's been the story of the night for them. For as well as St. Francis has played in this second half, they would be losing this game right now if Governor State could just knock down their free shots. Davis is trapped. Over to Charles, and the Jaguars are not fouling here. Charles gets it across to Davis. Davis takes it inside and now finally fouled. 16.7 on the clock, and that one's on Jeremiah Johnson, number 5 on him. Not very well played by Governor State. Number one, it's a big surprise that Tony Bates left Jeremiah Johnson on the floor for that defensive possession, knowing that one of his better offensive players was sitting on 4 fouls. So he's done for the day. Tyrell Isom was out there too. He was also sitting on 4 fouls. And number two, they let St. Francis use up over 10 seconds before committing the foul, which means that if Davis can hit one free throw here, it becomes a 3-possession game with precious few seconds to go. 1-1 for Davis, and he makes the first. And again, there's your difference. St. Francis leads the game by 7. They're at a +6 from the free throw line. Similar number of attempts. Davis makes 1 of 2. Desperation time for the Jaguars. Isom misses the 3. Rebound 1 by Ilatillo. He puts it back in. Just 7 seconds to play. And Tay Jones is fouled very quickly. So that should be about all. If Jones makes these 2 free throws, we'll call it pretty much official. I guess there is pretty much official. Either it's official or it isn't. It's 1-1 for Jones, so he's not even guaranteed 2 shots. Very good free throw shooter on paper. He makes the first. Jones has struggled sometimes from the line this year. But not tonight. Pretty much everything's been falling for Jones today. 18 points. Makes it a 3-score game, and now the Saints can just back off defensively. Ilatillo fires the long 3, gets it to go. And he makes this one a little bit tighter, but all the Saints have to do now is inbound it. They get it into Jones, and there's the final buzzer. 73-69, our final score. St. Francis defeats Governor State tonight, and the Fighting Saints pick up their 2nd consecutive victory. A hard-fought win for the Saints today. They trailed for much of the first half, fought back well when things weren't going their way, shots weren't falling for them early in this game, and then coming out of halftime, they were able to turn it around. They got some of their players back on the floor who had been stuck on the bench due to foul issues, and they were able to create a little separation, led by as many as 10. Governor State didn't go down easy. They kept fighting late. They made it a game in the final few minutes, but the Saints were able to keep scoring efficiently in the latter stages of the game, and they were able to pull out a 4-point victory. 73-69, our final score. We'll be joined by head coach Ryan Marks in just a few moments to talk it over. With the victory, St. Francis improves to 4-8 on the season and now 3-4 in conference play, and that puts them smack dab in the middle of the CCAC, where everybody, it seems, is hovering around 500 right now, including Governor State, who drops their overall record to 5-10 on the year, and they likewise are 3-4 in conference. Story of the game for the Saints today was Ronell Davis, 27 points. Tay Jones contributed with 18 as well. And we are now joined by the head coach of the Fighting Saints, Ryan Marks, who just picked up his 2nd victory. Coach, it was tough sledding early. You were without a couple of players who were in foul trouble, and you were able to turn things around and keep it going even with some of those guys on the bench. What was the key?
Yeah, I think we kept our poise. You know, those guys, it's an interesting matchup game. Different styles of play. I thought their aggressiveness and their quickness bothered us early, And I think our guys were able to kind of understand the things that we needed to do to try to accommodate that a little bit better. So I think keeping our poise, understanding what we needed to do to get the momentum going the other way was critical.
A couple of players stepped up as well. Rommel Davis ended up with 27 points today. Tay Jones had 18. They were hitting a lot of shots early in the game when shots really weren't falling for other guys. How big were their performances today?
Really, really big. You know, and as we've talked about, our roster's a little different than we originally anticipated. And those two guys in particular, EJ as well, when we've hit scoring droughts, sometimes we really lean on those guys. And, you know, they're doing it against defense that is, that is pretty laser focused on them. So I thought Rommel and Tay both played really well, poised, and obviously made big shots.
We talked before the game about not just getting moral victories, but actually putting wins in that win column. And you got another one today, two in a row. How big is it now to start to see that success come through in terms of results now going forward in the conference play?
I think it was huge for us because we played such a difficult early schedule. Lost so many close games. I mean, I think at a point that now, you know, we've seen a couple go in the W column. Even we have some really difficult ones coming up. But I think now, like, the belief that we can close out games, you know, under duress is, it's not going to be creeping in the back of my mind whether we can do it or not.
Well, I know you got a tough one coming up on Roosevelt on Saturday, so I'll let you go get ready for that one. Thanks for joining me here, and congratulations
Sounds
on the
great,
win.
Terry. Always appreciate it. Thanks.
Head coach Ryan Marks here on the postgame show from the University of St. Francis, where the Fighting Saints just took out the Jaguars of Governor's State by a final score of 73-69. The win is the second in a row for the Fighting Saints and improves their conference record to 3-4 and gets them right back in the mix after a slow start to the season as they fight for a spot in the conference tournament at the end of the season. That's going to do it for today's broadcast. Thanks for tuning in. The Saints head to the road. As just mentioned, they'll be at Roosevelt, the leading team in the conference, one of the top 25 teams in the nation. Downtown Chicago, it's going to be a tough one on Saturday. They won't return home until a week from that, January 20th. They take on St. Ambrose right here at the Sullivan Center. We'll have that broadcast for you, our next broadcast of men's basketball here at St. Francis again, January 20th against St. Ambrose. That's going to do it for today's broadcast. Thanks for tuning in as the Saints pick up a victory, 73-69 over Governor's State. Until next time, for the entire crew here at the Sullivan Center, this is Terry Bonadonna saying good night. Enjoy the rest of your Wednesday.